Since Halloween is slowly approaching, I got myself a pumpkin, emptied its guts, and tried carving it a scary looking face. You know, like everyone does during that time of the year. But for an electronics enthusiast like me, it is quite boring to just place a couple of small tea lights inside the pumpkin and be done with it. A better alternative would be a so-called ultrasonic mist maker. By placing it inside a container filled with water and powering it with a 24-volt power source, it creates a small water fountain along with a thin layer of fog. Of course, the LED light show is a nice bonus. But the main point of this gadget is that by positioning it inside the pumpkin, it makes it look a lot more interesting. Now, you can get such an ultrasonic mist maker for around $9 from eBay. But a while ago, I also bought myself two ultrasonic piezoelectric discs from eBay for only $2 each. Those are the main components of the mist maker. So the question of this DIY or buy episode is whether it would make sense to create our own driver circuit for such a piezoelectric disc, or whether we should just buy the commercial product instead. Let's find out. First off, let's remove the rubber sealing and the spring from the piezo disc and have a closer look at it. As you can see, there's really not much to it. Just a plain metal disc, you would say. But its resonance frequency of 1.7 MHz makes it special. If you would place it inside water and stimulate it with a 1.7 MHz AC signal, it would create a strong mechanical oscillation and therefore waves through the water. It is basically the same as when you pour water into a speaker cone and play back tones with different frequencies. The mechanical vibrations would create different waveforms on the surface of the water. By utilizing rather low frequencies, the water can easily follow the movement of the speaker cone. But on the other hand, when creating 1.7 MHz waves, the water particles cannot follow the oscillating surface, and thus create a momentary vacuum during the negative amplitudes, which therefore creates air bubbles. That is why during the positive amplitudes, tiny water droplets are catapulted into the air, quickly dissipate and take vapor form. And now with the theory out of the way, how can we create the required 1.7 MHz AC signal? One way to do so is by utilizing a full H-bridge, which consists of 4 MOSFETs. By turning on MOSFET 1 and 3, current would flow from left to right, and by turning on MOSFET 2 and 4, current would flow from right to left, which is obviously alternating and thus an AC signal. As a first test, I will use the full bridge that I built for my wireless energy transfer system. By connecting the piezo disc to the output, submerging it into water, powering the circuit with 12 volts, and measuring the oscillation frequency with an oscilloscope, we can slowly increase the frequency and search for the resonance point. Surprisingly though, the disc started creating a high-pitched sound at around 140 kHz, but without causing any effect on the water, which was weird. But once I reached a frequency of around 1.7 MHz, the disc actually started to create a noticeable bulge on the surface of the water. And by lifting it out a tiny bit, it was also capable of producing the fountain effect and thus the mist. But since my full bridge circuit consists of 4 MOSFETs, 2 MOSFET drivers, 1 555 timer, 1 hex inverter, dozens of passive components and a complicated schematic, it's not really worth building it for a mist maker due to its costs. But at least we got a proof of concept. So let's get rid of the full bridge and let's try something simpler. The first circuit that I came up with was a true sign of my genius, since I drew a simple 555 timer PWM circuit that turns on slash off a single MOSFET. After creating the circuit on a piece of perf board, the 555 timer did generate the required resonance frequency of 1.7 MHz and thus turned on slash off the MOSFET accordingly. But the problem was that this was still a DC voltage, not an AC voltage, which would let current flow in alternating directions instead of just one. So obviously, the piezo disc decided to do absolutely nothing. Brilliant. The next circuit I tried was a half bridge, which is simpler than a full bridge since it only consists of two MOSFETs while still being able to produce an AC signal. So I created a suitable schematic and soldered all the components to one another on a second piece of perf board. After then powering the circuits and trying to adjust the frequency, I noticed another fatal problem though. I utilized the IR2184 MOSFET driver. Since it features an easy to use bootstrap operation, only requires one control signal and includes a dead time to keep cross conduction losses low. But if we combine the dead time with the turn on slash turn off time, we can see that this switching process only allows a maximum frequency of around 690 kHz. That is why, while trying to increase the frequency up to 1.7 MHz, the MOSFET driver basically ignores the control signal at around 700 kHz. Now, I originally tried to stay away from the IR2113, which I utilized before with my full bridge, since it requires an additional inverted signal. But since it came to this, I soldered wire to its mandatory pins, added a Schmitt trigger next to it to create the inverted signal, and connected them to the 8-pin sockets of the IR2184 MOSFET driver. This time, I was capable of creating the 1.7 MHz AC voltage across the piezo disc. But even after changing the capacitor values, the disc did not react to the signal how I wanted it to. So as a last resort for the H-bridge circuitry, I simply got myself an L293 IC, which is basically a pre-made H-bridge. But after doing some calculations, I quickly realized that this H-bridge would also have been too slow, which led me to abandon the idea of using an H-bridge completely, and instead turn to an eBay seller, which supposedly offers a suitable oscillator circuit for the problem. After adjusting a couple of component values to what I had lying around, I soldered all the components to one another in mid-air, since I was tired of perfboard soldering. Once my piece of art was complete, I powered it up, measured the voltage across the piezo disc, and was actually greeted with an acceptable looking sine voltage. Only problem was that the frequency was around 140 kHz, and thus nowhere near the required 1.7 MHz. Even changing component values seemed to not influence the oscillation frequency greatly, which led me to believe that this could be a problem with the disc having a second resonance point, which we also experienced earlier. So in conclusion, after creating 5 circuits which were either too expensive or a complete failure, it would be wise to just buy the product instead of DIYing it, at least in my opinion. I hope you enjoyed watching my stupidity and at least learned something new along the way. If you have more ideas for DIY or buy episodes, feel free to share them in the comment section. As always, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Stay creative, and I will see you next time.